So I wait for my wife to leave, and then I coach my son on my year-long project, getting even with that goddamn bully. All right, buddy, honey, come on. We're going to practice, okay? We're just going to pretend that I'm the bully, and I step up to you, right? No, you don't got to be afraid. We're just pretending, okay? And I say to you, I come from a long line of civil war, blah, 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 whatever. You're going to say to him, it doesn't matter because we were here first. We jump-started America even before Columbus, that genocidal pedophilic rapist. Buddy, I'm telling you, he's going to shut the hell out of that bully, okay, my man? All right, so we good? We good? No, Dad, no. We didn't even go over my history homework, Dad. All right, honey, all right, I'm sorry. My bad. All right, so what's the assignment? Dad, I gotta do my project on heroes that I look up to. Well, dude, do it on some Latin heroes. Come on, man. Come on. It's a great idea. All right. You know what? We'll talk about it later. But you got your marching orders, right? All right. So go play like a normal kid. No, man. You got this. You gotta go play. Go. And I thought my son was gonna crush it in class, but he goes up to present on Columbus Day in front of his class, and he's all like, I know we've got lots of Latin heroes. I'm just working on getting their names and dates right now. But I do know for certain that Columbus was a genocidal pedophilic rapist. So, of course, the bully corners my son in the boys' bathroom. He's like, shut up. Your project sucks. Why don't you go back to your country, asswipe? Ow, ow, ow. Why don't you go back? Because we were here first, stupid. Oh, yeah? Prove it, dick face. Ow, ow, I will. I just got nothing on the facts right now. You're damn straight you ain't got nothing because you're the kings of nothing. Come here, king of nothing. Come here, because I'm going to crown your ass. Come here. What, are you going to run? You better run home and kill yourself, you little bitch. So my poor little broken man comes home, and he's all like, Dad, you just make up all this shit, Dad. I'm never going to believe you again. And he runs into his room. So I put on my best dad hat, and I go to him, and I says, buddy, honey, I'm sorry, but life is going to fuck you sometimes. It just is. And you're going to have to, I don't know, just keep changing positions until it feels good somehow. Okay, that didn't come out the way I meant it to come out. No. Honey, what I'm trying to say to you, buddy... Buddy, honey, what I'm trying to say to you is I made sure you grew up better than me so you wouldn't have to experience this. But in the streets, you can't let nobody punk you, man, so you got my permission to sucker punch that bully's ass, all right? And my son opens the door, and he's like, but Dad, Gandhi said that if we all took an eye for an eye, that the whole world would just be blind, Dad. Oh, but buddy, honey, Gandhi couldn't think straight because he was always hungry. My son doesn't get it. He doesn't know how the real world works. But I do, hell yeah. And as my father once said, and I wrote it down because he never said anything else to me again. I was afraid I'd forget. Here, let me. Every man has to measure himself in life. And how do you measure a man's value? But when he's tested in battle. So, yo, I was going to go to war on my son's behalf and get him real facts and real Latin war heroes. So behind his back, I get a copy of his 8th grade history textbook. And I'm looking for Latin heroes, and I'm looking for Latin contributions, and I'm looking from cover to cover, and there is nothing. Nada. Culo. Dick. I mean, it's unbelievable, man. Not one fucking sentence, not one fucking chapter, not a goddamn mention, as if we've been absent all these fucking centuries. And yo, I gotta fess up. That shit started to get me down. That is, until I get turned on to Howard Zinn's A People's History of the United States, which should be required reading for every kid in America because, yo, this book opened up the world to me, man. Because even in the first chapter, he proves that our contributions were even bigger than what I thought. Because we also gave you tomatoes, potatoes, chocolate. Try living without that shit, man. Hammocks, canoes, chili peppers, tobacco, anesthesia, brain surgery. And people from Jersey and Long Island? fucking hockey. And yo, it's not like the Europeans didn't give us anything. No, because they gave us typhus, cholera, malaria, measles, tuberculosis, black plague, the common cold, diphtheria, chicken pox, whooping cough, leprosy, and don't forget rats, roaches, and pigeons.